Welcome back to the Azure AD Architecture Deep Dive Series. I am Boateng-Kwakye, and I'm a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team at Microsoft.
And my name is Adrian Paredes, and I'm also a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team at Microsoft.
Our customers often ask, how does legacy authentication work? Why is it so bad? And what key parts of the process do they need to be aware of? In this video, we will discuss the flow of legacy authentication from start to finish using Federation with Azure Active Directory. Then we will cover legacy authentication flows using managed authentication. Adrian, can you walk us through how legacy authentication works with Federation?
Sure. First, we start from the application on the client machine. Let's say Outlook 2010 or an older version of Outlook. For example, when you open your email, the first thing it does is check with Office 365's Exchange Online service using basic authentication to see if the session is still active, as illustrated here in step one. Next, on step two, the Exchange Online service then calls out to Azure AD for the tenant configuration and to verify if it's federated or not using a process called Home Realm Discovery to fill in which domain you're logged in with. Once it verifies that you're federated, Azure AD lets the Exchange Online service know to go to a set endpoint previously defined in Azure AD based on the original configuration of federation with an authentication request, as illustrated here in step three. The federation server then contacts a domain controller to verify the username and password calling Windows native APIs for that user and sends it back to the Exchange Online service. From there, the Exchange Online service sends the SAML assertion token to the Azure AD authentication service. From here, Azure AD attempts to authorize the token from the federation server and also evaluates conditional access policies, which for legacy authentication only allows blocking. Upon authorizing the user to access Azure AD protected resources, such as Exchange Online, Azure AD issues a token and returns to the Exchange Online backend service, and this is strictly a server-to-server interaction. Now that Exchange Online has a valid token for the user, it returns the specific content to the user, in this case, the user's email. Audra, what happens if you don't use federation, but use managed authentication instead with legacy auth? Could you tell us how that works?
Absolutely. The managed authentication flow is very similar to federated auth, but instead of the validation against federation servers, we take the username and password and validate it directly in Azure AD, as we saw in the previous videos. We start with a user launching an Office 365 application. Again, in this case, we use Outlook 2010 and Exchange Online. The initial request goes to Exchange Online. Exchange Online then calls Azure Active Directory for the tenant configuration, which then verifies it's managed. The user is then prompted for their username and password through basic authentication. Exchange then sends the credentials to Azure AD for verification, as illustrated here in step three. Like federated authentication, the user is then evaluated against conditional access and identity protection policies for authorization. Upon completion of authorization, Azure AD then issues the token back to Exchange Online, which in turn allows access to the email for the requesting user.
I have a question, Audra. What exactly makes legacy authentication bad?
Legacy authentication is bad because there is no way to protect this with MFA or anything else. It is also the most used interface for attackers to break into environments using password spray, breach replay, and other techniques. As a result, Microsoft's recommendation is to block legacy authentication. Adrian, what is the best way to block it?
It is critical to block legacy authentication, which you can do via conditional access policies. But you also need to block legacy authentication at the Office 365 service. In this case, Exchange service to block the request at step one, as this is pre-authentication. This goes for federation as well as managed authentication. In addition, federated servers can also create policies to block legacy authentication.
Also, when you are using legacy authentication, please note that it is not capable of using true MFA. This means if you set a conditional access policy to require Azure MFA and the app is using legacy auth, it will not be able to process it the same way as if you were using a modern auth application. Modern authentication is a much better solution using either federation or seamless single sign-on with password hash sync or pass-through authentication, especially when you consider its security improvements.
Here are the key takeaways. First, It's important to understand that legacy authentication is simply not capable of using MFA, as it cannot handle that level of complexity. Despite any MFA policies you have, legacy auth will simply ignore it. Second, because of the limitations of legacy authentication, this is far and away the most targeted point by attackers, who typically use password spray or breach replay attacks. Next, you need to understand the impact of blocking legacy auth in your environment. How many 2010 Office apps are you using? But the bigger, more likely question is how much are you currently using Exchange Active Sync? Finally, you need to block all legacy auth in your environment, especially non-modern auth Exchange Active Sync. This needs to be done with conditional access policy, but also blocking at the service level, such as Exchange Online Service, using a multitude of tools, such as client access rules, to block legacy auth to prevent it from trying to authenticate. Remember, pre-authentication is at the service level, while post-authentication is done via conditional access.
That's great, Adrian. Thanks for sharing that with us. Thank you for watching this video. Be sure to check out our other architecture videos at aka.ms/identityyoutube. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.